Alcohol at the Kaneohe Sandbar is now banned permanently on several three-day weekends.
There had been some talk of a total ban, but instead the state land board tried to meet in the middle with boaters and sandbar users. Brianne Randall joins us now with our top story. Brianne?
Justin, if the governor gives the okay, there will be no possession of alcohol at the sandbar during specific three-day weekends. And possession doesn't mean in your hands, it means no alcohol anywhere on your boat.
The recent three-day Memorial Day weekend at the Kaneohe Sandbar is one the Board of Land and Natural Resources wants to see more of, and less of past holidays like these. During a public meeting today, the board took testimony whether it should make a rule banning alcohol in that area of Kaneohe Bay permanent.
We're concerned about the growing crowds of people in Kaneohe Bay, particularly around this island, and we're grateful that you're considering strengthening your rules to protect the area and for the public safety.
But most who spoke were against an alcohol ban at the sandbar.
This is an example where a few bad apples ruin it for everyone.
You don't make enforcement easier by saying that you just can't have any alcohol, period. That's scary.
The board went back and forth deciding how to craft a rule that would make the most sense, a debate that got heated.
It's a very slippery slope when you start passing rules like this that infringe upon people's rights. And if you start passing these rules, okay, and then you keep moving them around.
If we don't do this, you're out there and some obnoxious group comes out there. Wouldn't that bother you?
Some also argued that a ban on alcohol will just force the crowds elsewhere.
Because people will go, they don't like these three-day weekends. Why don't we do it on this coming Sunday?
But the board proposed a ban on the possession of alcohol within the sandbar safety zone, only over Memorial Day, Labor Day, and the 4th of July, when the holiday falls on a three-day weekend, for the next 3 years.
Going forward, if an officer sees somebody with what appears to be alcohol, that's the probable cause to go on board and verify there's alcohol aboard.
That means next year, since 4th of July does not fall on a three-day weekend, the proposed ban on alcohol would only impact Memorial Day and Labor Day weekends.
Now, the proposed rule change goes before the governor for his signature. If it's signed soon, the alcohol ban could take effect this coming Labor Day weekend in September. Brianne Randall, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.